Every region in Italy is very different. Still, people do not believe me. So this time, let's learn about the regions of Italy, A to Z, starting with Abruzzo. Abruzzo is a region of southern Italy, divided into four areas: L'Aquila, the capital, Teramo, Pescara, and Chieti. It joins the Apennine Mountains in the west to its beaches on the Adriatic Sea, which means that you can go to the beach and go skiing in the same holiday. Good, eh? Abruzzo is a very rural region. It has national parks and nature reserves. Abruzzo, Lazio and Molise National Park, the Gran Sasso and Monti della Laga National Park, Majella National Park and Sirente Velino Regional Park. The motto of the region is strong and kind, so be nice to the locals when you visit. Abruzzo is frequently ignored by visitors who head for Rome, Florence and Venice. Tourism in Abruzzo is more focused around the nature reserves, skiing and beach resorts around the Trabocchi Coast. At the same time, Abruzzo has a range of castles and beautiful medieval towns. For example, the fortress of Civitella is the most popular attraction in Abruzzo. Civitella del Tronto was the site of the last stand against Garibaldi during the unification of Italy in 1860. Sulmona's Holy Week celebration includes a procession of statues through the streets. Coccolo holds the Festa dei Separi, during which a statue of St. Dominic, covered with live snakes, is carried through the town. People from Abruzzo. The Roman poet Ovid was born in L'Aquila, but was eventually banished by Emperor Augustus. Pontius Pilate is believed to have been from Abruzzo. The co-writer of the movie La Dolce Vita, Ennio Flaiano, was born in Pescara. Pescara is heavily associated with the Italian writer Gabriele D'Annunzio. Now to the things that really matter. The region's most famous wine is Montepulciano d'Abruzzo. But don't forget Trebbiano d'Abruzzo. If you want to try a local liqueur, try Centerba. This area is a major producer of olive oil and durum wheat, which is used for pasta. In terms of cuisine of Abruzzo, this often includes lamb and mutton. Goat is also important, and it's used for meat, milk and cheese. So, for example, rivisondoli, pecorino d'Abruzzo, pecorino di Atri, scamozza di Abruzzo. These are kinds of local cheeses. Truffles and wild mushrooms are popular in the area. The food often includes hot chili pepper. Mortadella di Campodosto is a local variation. And ventricina is a local salame. More examples of local food. Spaghetti alla chitarra is a particular local pasta shape. Potato gnocchi carati, which I don't agree with, is another local speciality. Pasta allo sparone is pasta filled with ricotta cheese and spinach with a tomato sauce. Pasta alla mugnaia is thick pasta served in tomato sauce from Elice. Pallotte cacio e ovo are balls of caciocavallo cheese, which is delicious, and eggs in a tomato sauce. Baccalà all'Abruzzese is a variation on salted cod stew. As I've mentioned earlier, roast lamb is very popular here. Arrosticini, lamb skewers, are particularly a local speciality. Mozzarella is herby lamb intestines if you're feeling brave. Timbalo Abruzzese is a dish a bit like lasagna served up at Christmas and Easter, but it includes rice. Fiadani from Chieti is a dough made of eggs and cheese. A number of movies have been shot in the dramatic scenery of Abruzzo, and these include The American, starring George Clooney, The Name of the Rose, starring Sean Connery, Red Sonja, starring Arnold Schwarzenegger and Bridget Nielsen, Lady Hawk, starring Matthew Broderick, Rutger Hauer and Michelle Pfeiffer, King David, starring Richard Gere, Francesco, starring Mickey Rourke and Helena Bonham Carter, and of course, Krull. If you still need ideas on what to see, check out Rocca Calascio, Grotte di Stife, Lago di Scanno, Riserva Naturale di Punta Aderci, Campo Imperatore, La Camosciara, Riserva Naturale Statale Valle del Orfento, Lago di Barea. Now, a heavily contested category is Most Beautiful Village in Italy. And Abruzzo has 26 of the candidates. Abbateggio, Anversa degli Abruzzi, Bugnara, Campli, Caramico Terme, Casoli, Castel del Monte, Castelli, Città Sant'Angelo, Civitella del Tronto, Creccio, Guardia Grele, Navelli, Opi, Pacentro, Palena, Penne, Pesco Costanzo, Pettorano sul Gisio, Pietra Camella, Pretore, Rocca San Giovanni, Santo Stefano di Sessanio, Scanno, Tagliacozzo, which is also historically important, and Villa Lago. If you've enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a like and maybe subscribe to the channel. That way you can enjoy more of this content. Thank you. Click here for some more videos you may be interested in.